In the communal gardens on the edge of New Orleans, you'll find a neighborhood known as Little Saigon. It's home to the largest Vietnamese community in Louisiana. And at its heart sits the Dong Phuong Bakery. Renowned for its bread and pastries, it's the kind of place where friends and neighbors meet to talk about their problems. And for mother of two, Teresa Wen, it's her son Paul's education that she's most concerned about. And it's that breakdown in communication that's causing the most concern. Teresa's daughter Michelle has spent so much time translating for both her mother and Paul's teachers that she almost failed at school herself. Community leaders say the city is failing to provide Vietnamese students and other minorities with the language services they need. And now they've taken the drastic step of filing a complaint with the Department of Justice.
It's a shame on the school system. It's a shame on the state level when you see that this is what this country is pretty much built on, and that now you get to pick and choose who you service and who you don't.
This community then feels like it's being badly let down by a school system that is in many ways the pride of New Orleans. In the past few years, grades and graduation rates have been steadily improving across the city, but people here claim they're being denied access to a basic education.
It's a charge officials are taking seriously, and they're keen to point out that schools in New Orleans pride themselves on being inclusive. Here at the international school, pupils learn French, Spanish and Mandarin. Proof, say teachers, that this is a school system sensitive to its students' needs.
I think we've done a great job. So, you know, let's look at the positives of where we are. So academically, our schools are better off today than they've ever been in my lifetime.
But the Vietnamese community say drastic improvement is needed, and all they're asking for is the chance to get a better education. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, New Orleans, Louisiana.